Operational amplifiers have multiple applications. We have already covered two applications. First was an inverting amplifier, the second was a non-inverting amplifier. I'll be starting this video with the assumption that you have already looked at the simulation of an inverting amplifier. So when we use LTSpice, this is what an inverting amplifier looks like. The op-amp that we are using is LT1012. So if you see this right now and we just run the circuit that we have made, at the input I have given a voltage of 20 millivolts, that is 10 millivolts peak to peak, and when I see the output you are getting the gain of minus RF by R1, so that is 10k by 1k, gain is minus 10, so your output is going from minus 100 millivolts to plus 100 millivolts. If I have to convert this circuit to an inverting adder, the first thing that we will do is, since it is an adder circuit, I wouldn't want a gain of 10. I want the gain to be 1. It's an inverting amplifier, so your gain will be minus 1. So I have taken this value as 1k. Now the next thing that I have to do, since I am creating an adder, I will need two inputs. So you take another resistor, use Ctrl R to rotate it, and let's place the resistor over here. And we will also need another voltage source. So select a voltage source from the components and say I place it over here. Click on escape. You need a ground connected to the voltage source. Make all your connections. So I'm going to connect the voltage source to the resistor. And I have made these connections. So these are my two inputs. The value of R will be the same, that is 1K. This voltage source, so I'm going to hover over the voltage source till I get the symbol. Right click, go to advanced, select the sine waveform. Your DC offset will be 0. Say that I'm using a 20 millivolt input at the same frequency, that is 50 Hertz. All other values are going to be 0. And I click on OK. I just want to move this a little to the side, so I click on F7, click on this and get it over here. So I can clearly see my two inputs. Now when I run the program, let me keep a separate window, so I'm going to add plot pane. On the first pane, I'm taking the first input, which is over here. So that is a 20 millivolt signal. I will also add another plot pane where I can see the input. So let me see the second input, that's at this point, which is a 40 millivolt signal. Okay, so you can see both of these signals are in phase. Our expected output would be a 40 millivolt plus a 20 millivolts, or 60 millivolt signal, that will be going from minus 30 to plus 30 millivolts. So you select this, come here. And look at your output that you've got. This is going from minus 30 to plus 30. Since the gain is minus RF upon R1 or minus RF upon R2, you can see that this waveform is exactly opposite of what you got on top. Now when you look at your waveforms like this, it doesn't look like there is a gain. So one thing that we could do is try and get all the waveforms on a single plot. So I'm going to take a single plot. The one that you have right now is the second input, so I'll take the first input as well. Okay, so these are my two inputs and I want to see the output. So the red color signal is your output, the green color one is your 20 millivolts peak to peak, this is 40 millivolts peak to peak, and the final one that I have got right here is my 60 millivolt peak to peak signal. This is how we use an op-amp as an inverting adder. In the next experiment that we do, we will be seeing how to use an op-amp as a differential amplifier or as a basic subtractor circuit.